Welcome to Hyperfine Academy. Today we're talking Revit dimensions. 12 tips in 5 minutes to help you get started and become more efficient with your dimensions. Tip number one, when working in dimensions, it's good to use thin lines. The view right here shows how Revit will plot your image with your line weights that you've assigned. TL is the thin lines command. You can see this makes it easier to see your wall layers, makes it easier to see things and set dimensions to them. Number two, creating dimensions. That's the whole point of this video. Use DI to enter your dimension tool. Zoom into what you want to see. The blue line will be what Revit dimensions to. You can tab through to get what you want. When the blue line is where you want it, left click, come find your next object, repeat the process, left click again, then click off to the side where you're not going to hit anything, just a blank area, and there's your dimension. Escape will close out the dimension tool. If you decide you want to change an object that you've dimensioned to, we can see up here I've actually got the outside of the wall when I wanted the stud. Select your dimension and look for these two leaders. The inner leader closer to the dimension will be what you're actually dimensioned to. I can left click on this, drag through, and then repeat that process from the previous step where I'm just going to tab through to get what I want, and you see the dimension has moved. This leader is for visual purposes only. If you want to add dimensions, you close it out too early, you can always do that. Select the dimension, come up to edit witness line, and now we're just sort of starting them from scratch like we did before. It's just going to add them to the string. Tab through to get what you want, click off to an empty area, and now you've added those dimensions to that string and it's updated. To delete dimensions from the string, it's just the same process in reverse. Select your dimension string, edit witness line, zoom in, you can see that these lines are blue. That's where Revit is actually got a leader attached to. If we click on those again, it'll go away. Get both of them, click off to the side. Now those dimensions are gone off your string. To change a dimension to be a value that you want it to be, the best thing to do is to actually model your project correctly. If you have dimensions going to an object like this wall, and you select that object, you'll see the dimension will turn light blue. If you do a single click, you'll open it up and you can just type in what you want. You can see I'll just type in 11 space 9, and I get 11 foot 9 inches. Click off to the side, and your dimension is updated. There are some instances where you want to round a dimension. If that's the case, select your dimension and edit type. I hit ET, that's a custom shortcut, more on that at the end of the video. Duplicate to create a new type, and give it a name that makes sense. I'll scroll down, look for units format, uncheck use project settings, and then at rounding, I will check the level of detail that I want, quarter inch. Now my dimensions are rounded. Sometimes you might not want a dimension, you just want to show that something like a window is centered in a room. In that case, with your dimension selected, just hit this EQ button and you'll see it centers at the room, gives you that equal symbol. You can turn off the EQ symbol by pressing that EQ button again, and there you'll see the dimension even on both sides. You can also change that EQ text by doing edit type, scrolling down and changing it here. I would keep it with the EQ. You can also do this for multiple items. Just keep in mind that in this case, the center lines are evenly spaced, but not necessarily the space between the windows. To keep your plans clean and more easily readable, it's nice to remove unnecessary information. In this case, we don't need 0 feet showing when the dimension is only 5.5 inches. If we select the dimension, edit type, come back down to units format, and we will suppress 0 feet. Now that 0 feet goes away. In some cases, you're going to want the entire dimension string to read inches, not just when it's below 1 foot. This is a time when you're definitely going to want to edit type and duplicate, so you don't change this for every dimension string in your project. Select your dimension, edit type, duplicate, rename it, and come down to units format. We'll choose fractional inches. Now my dimension is in inches. You can also add nodes and symbols directly to the dimension strings if you need them to convey more information than just the dimension value. Double-click directly onto one of these values, and you'll open up the dimension text dialog, where you can add symbols and other text. Plus minus is Alt-0177 on your number pad. You can add centerline symbols to the dimension strings. I should have done this earlier, but I forgot, and I didn't want to go back and redo all those number graphics. Select your dimension, edit type, scroll down till you see centerline symbol, and choose centerline. Hit OK, and there it is. Any dimension that goes to the actual centerline of an object will automatically get that symbol. If you didn't have that available, load family, go to annotations, and there it is right there. And that's it. That was 12 tips in 5 minutes to help get you started and to become more efficient with your Revit projects. I've used a few custom shortcuts in this tutorial. If you want to get them for free, visit hyperfinearchitecture.com. The link will be in the description. If you have a request for a specific topic, please leave a comment. And thank you for watching. All right, we got one more. You've got a string of dimensions. If you want to break it up into two or more strings, just tab through to the one you don't want and delete.